Hello students, I am Sharanya Babu, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, AJIIT, Mangalore. So today we will be discussing on the searching and sorting techniques that comes under the module 3 arrays. And the searching and sorting techniques which we are doing here is based on the one-dimensional array. So in my previous two videos I had done explaining the array concepts and also some of the programs, important programs that comes under the arrays. Okay, so today I'll be moving on to searching and sorting techniques. Even these two techniques are making use of the one-dimensional array. And please refer your notes which has been already shared with you. The today's topic which I'm covering is from page number 8 to page number 12. Okay, I'm repeating, please refer your notes which is shared with you from page number 8 to page number 12. So today that is what the topics at which we are going to cover. So coming to the searching and sorting techniques. So we will see each one in detail, what is searching technique and what is sorting techniques. We'll start with searching techniques. So what do you mean by searching techniques? Searching means what? As the name suggests, we are finding some items, right? So here in array, what we can find? We can find an element, because array is filled with elements that are of same data type. So here it is a process of finding a particular item in a large amount of data. It is called as searching. And the technical term that which we are using, the element that you are searching for is called as key element. Understood? Key element. Which element? Suppose I am asking the program. I want the program to find an element 9 in the array, in the present array. So that time that 9 becomes the key element. Understood? That 9 becomes the key element. So that is what, whichever item you are searching for, that becomes the key element. Now there are two methods of searching. One is linear search and one more is binary search. We will be discussing linear search and binary search. Please go through the video that I have done for the palindrome and binary search. There is one video which is palindrome and binary search. In that I have explained the program binary search, and also I had mentioned you regarding the linear searching technique. Okay, so once again I'll repeat it here, but please go through that video if you want to know in detail about the binary search. So coming to linear search and binary search, both are searching techniques. Linear search is also a searching technique, binary search is also a searching technique. First we will be starting with linear search. Okay, we'll be starting with the linear search. So what is this linear search? See, it is also called as sequential search. You can see here, linear search is also called as sequential search, and it is a simplest searching technique. In this technique, what we are doing is we are searching for a given key item in linear order. What do you mean by linear order? At a stretch, right? From this end to this end, at a straight like this we are going. So linear order means one after the other, from the first element to the last element, from this end to the other end. We are searching from here till here, till the other end we will be searching. If you find the key in between, you will get it as successful. Otherwise, it is unsuccessful. The key item is present, the search is successful. Otherwise, it is unsuccessful. So always remember, as the name says, linear search, it is like from one end to another end, you are searching all the elements. Clear? You are searching from the first element to the last element. Whether the key is matching from the first element to the last element, every element will be checked. Fine. So here we are going to write a C program to perform a linear search for a key element in an array. We'll see the program how we are doing it. Okay. So how we will be starting? As usual, header file, main function. Then I want to declare as one-dimensional array. How will I declare one-dimensional array? You already know that. You are declaring a one-dimensional array. After that, looping variable I is required. Then the total number of array elements, count, array limit, that is being stored in n, and which item you are searching for, that is always called as key element, right? So I need a variable called as key in order to hold it. Then what? Printf enter the number of elements. Enter the number of elements means what is the array limit? How many arrays or how many array elements you are going to insert? So here you will get the value. You have to read and store it in the variable n. After that, what? Once you get the array, how many number of elements are you going to store? Next, what do you want? You want those array elements, right? The values of arrays you want. So next, what you will be asking? printf enter the array elements. You'll ask the user to enter those array elements. So tell me, how will you enter the array elements? You will start from 0th position of the array to n minus 1 to the nth position. You will read each element from the user, each value from the user, and store it in its appropriate location. This is the reading part, you already know. Correct? These steps are mandatory for all one-dimensional array things. Okay, first is the array size you want, then the array elements you want, starting from 0th position to n minus 1 position. So read it and store it in the array positions. After that, what we have to search for that key element, right? Now you got the array elements, you know, you have the array element. How will you search for it? So before that, you ask the user, enter the key element that you want to search. User will enter the element, enter the value, read and store it in the element and the variable key. Okay. So next, you have got the key element that you want to search for. After that, what happens? See, if you want to search for a key element in an array, what does the linear search means? It starts from the first element till the last element, right? From the first element till the last element, you're going to search with each element whether the key is matching. So what you're doing, you're repeatedly checking each element, right? You're repeatedly checking each element. So for any repeated kind of actions, what do you require? You require looping statements. So which looping statements you can, any looping statements you can use, I've used for loop here. Again, same way like how I've done for reading the elements, reading the array elements of for loop. Same for loop has been used even here. For equal to 0, I less than an i++. After that, what? We are checking if any of those array element is equal to key element. Understood? If a of 5 and I is equal to 0, you are checking a of 0. That means 0th element position. 0th positioned element. Clear? A of 0. A of 0 means 0th positioned element. Whether that is equal to key. If that is equal to key, printf key element is found at position. Okay? Key element is found at so and so position. So key element, that key value is percentage t, is found at position percentage dy. We are giving I plus 1 because our positioning is starting from 0. So exact position if you want, you have to give I plus 1. Clear? And then exit. If the key is found, you can come out of the program. Exit 0. Okay? Otherwise what? Close the for loop. Printf key is not found. You have finished searching the entire list. That's why we are closing the for loop here. Understood? You are closing the for loop. That means you're done with the searching. Still, if you have not found, it is key is not found. Okay, so now we are done with the program part. So you can see then the output. Enter the number of elements. If you insert 5 elements, enter the array elements 1, 2, 7, 9, 10. Now what you want to find the key element. If the key element is given 7. So the key element 7 is found at position 3. First, second, third position. Third position we have found. And see here, there is no necessity that you have to enter the array elements in ascending order and all. Whereas in binary search, you have to, because it is dividing the array into two halves. Whereas in this kind of things, you no need to take the elements in ascending or descending order. Now we are going to see the analysis part, okay? So where is the analysis part? Analysis part means we are checking only this part. Understood? The previous program, the previous part is reading an array. Reading an array declaration, reading the elements, reading the array, that and all we are not going. We are just seeing the searching part. This much is our searching part. So we are going to analyze that searching part with one example. So you can see here, we have for the for loop the same thing. If a of I equal to key, printf the key element is found. We are taking one example. Total number of elements are 5. Okay, there are total 5 elements. Which is a key element? 7 is the key element. Same output. The output whatever we have got, same thing we are taking. Okay, what is the input that you have? Array elements 1, 2, 7, 9, 10. 1 is at 0th position. A of 0. Why A of 0? Because array name is A. If I had given ARR, then it should be ARR. You are also ARR of CEO. So the name, this name is up to you. This is based on you. So this is A of 0 means 0th positioned element, A of 1 next element, A of 2 7, A of 3 9 and A of 4 10. Okay. This is our actual, the whatever you have read from the user, you are storing it in the array named A. Next, what is happening? First step, okay. In the first step, what is I value? I is equal to 0, right? When I is equal to 0, what is the next condition? Whether I is less than N. What is I value? 0. What is N value? 5. 0 less than 5. It is true. So if it is true, what happens? Directly, the condition will get, the statement under the for loop will get executed. Understood? In for loop, how it works? Initialization, condition checking. If the condition is true, statement gets executed, then comes the increment or decrement part. Okay. So here also I is equal to 0, 0 less than 5, condition is true. So this part gets executed. What is that part? What is that part? The part is if A of 0 is equal to key. Is it clear? If A of 0 is equal to key. By that it is A of 0 C. What is I value? 0. The condition is I less than N, 0 less than 5. It is true. Then what is the if condition? So that is why once the condition is true, the statements under the for loop gets executed. What is the statements under for loop? Statements under for loop is so and so, right? This much is the statements under for loop. So what is getting happened here? If A of I is equal to key, what is I value here? 0. If A of 0 equal to key. What is A of 0? How will you access an array element? Array name with index value. That is how we can access the value in it. A of 0 means, what is there in A of 0? 1. Is 1 equal to 7? No, it is false. So if it is false, whether this will execute? No, this part will not execute. So what happens then? It comes out of the if condition and I plus plus executes. So if A of I is equal to key, if A of 0 equal to key, if 1 equal to 7, false. So directly it come out of the if condition and I plus plus will occur. So now what is I value? I got incremented, right? So now I is equal to 1. So 1 less than N is 5 itself, 1 less than 5, true. So if it is true, what happens? The condition inside for loop will get executed. What is the condition? The statement inside the for loop, if A of 1 is equal to key. What is A of 1? It is 2. Is 2 is equal to 7? No, false. So it comes out of if condition and I plus plus will execute. Comes out of if condition and I plus plus will execute. This part will not execute. Then again, I got incremented to 2. Now 2 less than 5. 2 less than 5. Condition is satisfied. So statements under for loop will get executed. What is the statements under for loop? It is like if A of 2 is equal to key. Clear? So now A of 2. What is A of 2 value? It is 7. Is 7 equal to what is key value? 7. Is 7 equal to 7? True. So what happens? The statements gets executed, that is printf the key element percentage d is 100 position percentage d key I plus 1 gets executed. Now tell me the values of percentage d. The key element percentage d means key value, variable in key. What is variable in key? That is 7. Is found at the key element 7 is found at position percentage d. This percentage d is I plus 1. What was the latest I value? You should always remember the latest where the for loop stopped. What was I value at that time? What was I value at that time? I was equal to 2. So 2 plus 1. That means it is found at location 3. Okay. So here key is 7. You can see here key is 7 and I plus 1, I equal to 2. So 2 plus 1, that is position is 3. Understood? So this is how you are finding the or you are performing the linear search. So linear search will compare your actual element your actual element with the first element to the last element. Okay, it keeps on checking with each of the element whether key is equal to this, 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 whether key is equal to this. Understood? In between, if we find a match, it comes out of the program. That means we have found it. Just print the position. That's all. So this was about which one? Linear search. Clear? So linear search means understood. It is starting from the searching will start from the first element till the last element. It keeps on searching with all the adjacent elements. So that is what linear search. Now coming to binary search, we had already seen how binary search is working. Clear? We already know how binary search is working. So how binary search, it is a simple and efficient searching technique which can be applied in items arranged. See, what is the condition of binary search? The items should be arranged in either ascending or descending order. The first element in the array is considered as low and the last element is considered as high. Position of middle element is found by taking first and last, that is low plus high whole divided by 2, that is going to give you the mid value. Then the mid element is compared with the key element. If they are same, search is successful. Otherwise, if the key element is less than the middle, then searching continues in the left part of the array. If the key element is greater than the middle, then searching is done in the right part of the array. So this procedure will repeat until you find the key element. Clear? So this is what happening. So this is what is happening in binary search. Okay. Sorry, this is what that happens in binary search. So always linear search means each element it will check. Binary search will divide the list, array into two halves and start searching. If the key is greater than the middle element, searching goes to the right hand side. If the key is less than the middle element, searching goes to the left hand side. Clear? So this is what is happening in binary search. So both linear search and binary search is important. Binary search I've already explained with the program output tracing and all. You can refer the videos palindrome and binary search which I have done. In that binary search is explained in detail. Okay. So now we will be moving on to the next topic, that is under searching and searching and sorting technique. Is it right? So sorting technique. So next we will be seeing the sorting techniques. Okay, now coming to sorting techniques. So what do you mean by the term sorting? Arranging, right? You're arranging the items. While arranging the items, which are the different ways that you can arrange the item? The process of arranging elements in either ascending order or descending order is called sorting. There are one is bubble sort and another one is selection sort. These are the two sorts that which we are going to study here, bubble sort and selection sort. Okay, these two sorting techniques we will be studying here. And please remember the bubble sort, the theory part which I am explaining, and also the program, please listen carefully. Bubble sort is your lab program as well. Okay, it comes under the lab program as well. So kindly listen to the bubble sort and as well as selection sort. Bubble sort is also your lab program. So now we'll start with bubble sort. Okay, bubble sort. What do you mean by the term bubble sort? Bubble means what? Bubbling up, right? So here, why this particular sorting technique has got the title bubble sort, that we have to identify first. Okay. Bubble sort is the easiest one, simplest one and easiest one. In this technique, two successive elements of an array such as A of j and A of j plus 1 are compared. A of j and A of j plus 1 means two nearby elements are compared, neighboring elements. If I start with the first element, first and the second element are compared. The adjacent, the neighboring elements are compared to each other. And if they find any, if the existing element, I started comparing A of j and A of j plus 1. A of j means if the first element is A of j, the second element is A of j plus 1, okay? they are compared. If the first element AFG is greater than or equal to FJ plus 1, what we have to do? We have to swap them. Okay? So, swap them means we have to learn the swapping technique as well. I have already taught you the swapping program also. Refer to the previous videos. Swapping programs and all, we have done it in the previous module, second module. So, go through the videos, learn about the swapping as well. So, now if A of J is greater than or equal to A of J plus 1, then they are exchanged, right? We can exchange the values. Exchanging means we are just swapping it. This process repeats till all elements of an array are arranged in ascending order. This will continue until you get the sorted array in an ascending order. What do you mean by ascending order? From smallest to largest. Here you will get in an ascending order. So now after each pass, the largest element in the array sinks at the bottom and the smallest element in the array is bubbled towards up. Fine. So the largest element will go down and the smallest element will bubble up. That is why it is called as bubble sort, or also it is called as sinking sort. Okay. Bubble sort, or also it is called as sinking sort. So what happens in each pass, once you start with each phase, after each phase, what happens is the lowest element will be bubbled up and the highest element will be sinking at the bottom. Okay, it will come towards down, it sinks at the bottom. So that is why we have given the term sinking sort and bubble sort. Any one name is appropriate. Okay, sinking sort and bubble sort. Bubble sort algorithm compares each pair of adjacent. This is what I said. It compares the adjacent or the neighboring elements, and the elements are swapped if they are not in the ascending order. So what we need to do, we want that entire array in ascending order. So in order to make it in the ascending order, we'll keep on swapping them. Okay, we'll keep on swapping them. So how the swapping happens, or how we are doing, it will compare each pair of the adjacent elements, neighboring elements, it will be comparing. So listen here, students, see this diagram properly. See that it is okay here. You can either call it a step or pass one or phase. Okay, I might use the term phase or pass, anything is fine. Step, phase, pass, anything you can call for these things. Step one, step two, phase one, phase two, phase three, phase four, or pass one, pass two, pass three, pass four, that is also fine. So now listen carefully. This is your input that you are getting. What is the input that you have got? See the array elements. It is minus 2, 45, 0, 11 and minus 9. This is what we are having the array list. Okay, ignore the remaining all these things. These things you just ignore. We'll start with here. Okay, minus 2, 45, 0, 11 and minus 9. What do you mean by bubble sort? What it does? It will take the first element. It checks with its neighboring element. Minus 2 and 45. This is A of J. Okay, minus 2. I am starting with the 0th element, right? So this is A of 0 and this is A of 0 plus 1. That is why it is A of J and A of J plus 1. Understood? You are always comparing with the next element. So plus 1. The location plus 1. This is A of 0, right? A of 0 plus 1. That is the next location. Understood? That is why if A of J is greater than or equal to A of J plus 1, swap them. Okay. Is minus 2 greater than 45? Is minus 2 greater than 45? No. Right? So minus 2 will be kept in its position itself. Okay. Next my concentration will move on to 45. Because no need to swap. Minus 2, let it be in its position. 45 will start. Now, 45 and 0. Okay. 45 and 0. Now A of J is 45, A of J plus 1 is 0. I am checking only with its neighboring element. So 45 and 0. Is 45 greater than or equal to 0? Yes. So what we have to do? We have to swap its position. So 0 will come here, 45 will go there. Okay. So now we are swapping according to the position. We are checking according to the position. So remember, this position is checked. Then we started with this position. So now we have to start with this position. So again, don't think that since 45 is compared, I have to ignore. No, next is from the next position. These two positions are done, right? First we started with this position, then start with this position. Now we have to start with this position. Okay. Now 45 and 11. Okay, 45 and 11. Is 45 greater than or equal to 11? Yes. So what we have to do, 45 is greater than 11, right? So what we have to do, we have to swap it. 11 should come here, 45 should go there. Okay, I'm done with the swapping. Now what happens? Now it is, I have to start with 45. Is 45 greater than or equal to minus 9? Yes, 45 is greater than minus 9. So what we have to do again, swap it. So in the first pass or in the first step or in the first phase, my final array is minus 2, 0, 11, minus 9, 45. Now my question is this array sorted? Is this array sorted, the final one which you have got at the end, is this array sorted? No, this is not a sorted array, right? You have not got it as a sorted array. So what we will do, this will be given as the input. We'll continue the next phase or we'll continue with the next pass. Okay?
Yes.
So I'll move on to the next pass. This is the second pass or the second phase will come here. So what is the input? Minus 2, 0, 11, minus 9 and 45. Now I'll start comparing with, it is now my a of j is minus 2, a of j plus 1 is 0. Start from the first location itself. You're starting with a new phase, a new pass. See, what we are doing, we are starting with the first element compared to the second element, then second element with the third element with the fourth element, then the fourth element with the fifth element. After that, we have got one array, right? We have got one array. Now what we have to do, we have to send it for the next phase of sorting. So in the next phase of sorting, I have to start again, start from the beginning, first position. What is there in the first position? Minus 2, 0. Is minus 2 greater than or equal to 0? No, it is less than, right? Minus 2 is less than. So no need of swapping. Let minus 2 be there itself. It will come to 0. 0. Okay, value 0. Now, who is the neighbor of 0? Who is the neighbor of 0? 11. Now, 0 and 11 are checked. Which is 0 greater than or equal to 11? No. Correct? 0 is less than 11, right? 0 is not greater than. So again, no need of swapping. Only if it is greater than, then you swap. Is 0 greater than 11? No. So no need of swapping. So what we will do here? Now I'll check the, who is the neighbor of 11. Who is the neighbor of 11? Minus 9. Is 11 greater than minus 9? Yes. So what we have to do? We have to swap its position. 11 will come here. Minus 9 will go there. So now it is minus 9, 11, and then comes 45. Now my question is, now even you will have a doubt why this 11 and 45 is not checked. Why we are not checking? Because already the largest element, the last positioned element is already sorted out. We have found out, right? Only always the largest element in the first pass, sorry, in the first pass itself, the largest element in the array will be sinking at the bottom. Now we got the bottommost element is done in the first pass. So I need not compare again 11 with 45. There is no use. I can stop it before that. Okay. Now what is my final array in the second pass or in the second step? Minus 2, 0, minus 9, 11, 45. Is my array sorted? No, it is not sorted. So it will be the input of next phase or it will be the input of the next pass. What is the input of the next pass? Minus 2, 0, minus 9, 11, 45. Clear? So now what we will be comparing? We will be comparing minus 2 with 0. Again, start the first position. Is minus 2 greater than 0? No. So no need of swapping. Now come 0 and minus 9. Is 0 greater than minus 9? Yes, 0 is greater than minus 9. So what happens? We need a swapping here, right? We need to swap this. So now the new array will be minus 2, minus 9, 0, 11 and 45. Clear? Minus 2, minus 9, 0, 11 and 45. But do you have to again compare these two elements? Can you see one thing? In this first pass, every elements were checked till the last element. See this arrow. See this arrow. Till the last element it was checked. But now we got an array where the last element is sorted. So in the second pass, I am not checking the last element. I am stopping my sorting here. Okay, I am stopping my checking over the second last element. What about the third pass? See, third pass, the two places are left. Clear? Because those two, in the first pass or in the first step, 45 got sorted. In the second pass, the 11 got sorted. So again, I need not check those two. So once I check 0 and minus 9, yes, there is a 0 is greater than, swap it. So now my new array is minus 2, minus 9, 0, 11 and 45. This is what we are getting. Now this is going to be the input array for the third pass. Okay, in the third pass, this is going to be the fourth pass or in the fourth step. So minus 2, minus 9, 0, 11, 45. You can start with minus 2, minus 9. So minus 2, minus 9, what is the this thing? Swap, whether swapping is required? Is minus 2 greater than minus 9? Yes, minus 2 is greater than minus 9. So what happens? You have to swap it and then it will be minus 9, minus 2, 0, 11, 45. So now I am done with all the steps, right? And the previous step 11 and 45, now 0, 11 and 45, minus 9, minus 2 are also got swapped. Now all the positions are sorted. Is it clear? So in the first pass, we will stop the swapping one position before the last two, until the last one, then one position, then two position, then three positions. Clear? So this is how bubble sort will work. So the lowest elements will be bubbled up and the largest element will be sinking at the bottom. Fine. So this is how this one bubble sort will be working. Remember, bubble sort is your lab program as well. Okay, bubble sort is your lab program as well. So now we'll see the program. Develop a program to sort the given set of numbers using bubble sort. As usual, your header file, main function. Then what is this? End day of 20, end temp, ij. What is temp? Why temporary variable is required? Because we need to swap, right? If the number is greater than, then we need to swap it. We need to swap it. So now this is the declaration part. Then enter the number of elements, array size. You read it and store it in the variable n. Then printf, enter the array elements, reading the actual array values. How? Using the for loop, I equal to 0, I less than an I plus plus, read the element and store it in its appropriate location. Okay, reading the array elements are done. Next, the task will start here. So now, before the task starts, I have to show the diagram once again. You can see here how many steps are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Or how many phases are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. So tell me total number of elements here. How many elements were there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So n is equal to 5, right? N is equal to 5. So when n is equal to 5, tell me the total number of phases or steps here. 5 minus 1, that is n minus 1. Is it clear? So my step will start from 1 to n minus 1. Is it clear? N minus 1 from first step. So my first for loop will be I is equal to 1, I less than n. Okay. Instead of n minus 1, I have given just I less than n. Why we are starting from I equal to 1? Because that step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4 or phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4. So that is why it is starting from 1. Now, this is to keep track of those steps. Which steps? To keep track of these steps. For I equal to 1, this step. For I equal to 1 means this steps. For I equal to 2 means this step. For I equal to 3 means this step. For I equal to 4 means this step. Is it clear? So this is what it is happen. So outer for loop is to keep track of these steps or phases. The outer for loop is used to keep track of these phases or steps. Now inside each step, see properly inside the step 1 or inside this phase 1, tell me how many swappings are taking place? 1, 2, 3. Sorry, swapping in the sense how many checkings are taking place. Which all elements? How many elements we have to check? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 checkings are being done, right? Understood? So now, the outer for loop will keep track of these steps. When I is equal to 1, that means we are in the first phase. For I equal to 1 means we are in the first phase. Inside the first phase, another for loop is used to perform this checking. Another for loop is used to perform this checking. Is it clear? So always remember, the outer for loop in this program is used to keep track of the steps or phases. And when for I equal to 1, when the outer for loop I is equal to 1, that means you are in the first phase, phase 1 or step 1. That time, one more for loop is required to iterate through these elements. So now see the for loops here. For I equal to 1, I less than n. Then another for loop j, j equal to 0, j less than n minus I. Why it is n minus I? Why it is n minus I? See that diagram. in that j equal to 0, right? Say why j equal to 0? We are starting from the 0th element. See, in all the steps, the checking starts from the 0th element itself, right? The checking starts from 0th element. But how many checkings are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 checkings. That means for j equal to 0, j less than n minus I. That means n is total number of elements, that is 5. 5 minus, what is I value? 1. 5 minus, in pass 1 or in phase 1, how many checkings are being done? Tell me how many checkings are being done. 1, 2, 3, 4. That means in pass 1, it is j equal to 0 to n minus 1. Okay, 4. Step 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, because that time j will get incremented to 2. When 2 is a thing, n minus 2. That means 5 minus 2. It is 3. Step 3. Okay. 0 to 5 minus 3. How many checking? 2. This one 5 minus 4. 1 checking. Understood? So in the first step, how many checkings are there? 5. Total number of element is 5. 5 minus that step number. 5 minus 1. 4 checkings. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, pass 2. Total number of elements are 5. 5 minus, since it is in the second step, we will be reducing 1. 5 minus 2. So now only 1, 2, 3 checkings. Step 3, total elements of 5, total number of elements of 5. 5 minus 3, only 2 checkings. Then step 4, 5 minus 4, there is only 1 checking. Is it clear? So the outer for loop is for these steps and the inner for loop is to maintain this swappings, or in order to maintain this checking the elements. To check the elements, we have inner for loop. Okay, so that is what here. For I equal to 1, I less than, and this is for outer for loop is for the steps or pass. The inner for loop, j equal to 0, from 0 to position it will start till n minus I, for step 1 till 4th. Okay, so that many elements it keeps on checking. What we are checking is that element j is greater than j plus 1. That means whether the first element is greater than the second element. Okay, the checking element is greater than its next element. If it is greater than, swap it. How you will swap? We have already seen the swappings, right? Same thing. Temp equal to a of j equal to fj. Temp equal to fj means that current value will be stored in temp. Then a of j will be filled with the next positioned element. Then whatever is there in temp will go to a of j plus 1. See, this j plus 1 are all locations. It means location. So this is swapping. If the element is greater than the next element, swap it. Fine. After that, close this inner for loop, close this outer for loop. Then print the sorted elements R for I equal to 0. Because for printing elements also, always remember, for reading and for printing, we need this for loop. So for I equal to 0, less than I plus plus, print it. Fine. So this is how you are doing the bubble sort. Is it clear, everyone? So what we are doing, outer for loop for the steps, total number of steps, inner for loop for the checking inside each step. Then if the current element is greater than its next element, swap it. Okay. So then once it is done, close all the for loop, print of the sorted elements are so and so. For printing also, it requires for loop. Fine. So this is the bubble sort technique. Okay, this is the bubble sort technique. So this is the output under the number of elements 5, 30, 2, 18, 12. The sorted elements are the sorted. Okay, now coming to selection sort. Okay, the next topic is selection sort. What is selection sort? Bubble sort we have seen. Bubble sort means what? The largest element will be sinking at the bottom and the lowest element will be bubbled up. Okay, it will be like just like bubbling up. Now coming to selection sort, what do you mean by selection sort? Here, the list is divided into two parts. No, don't get confused. It is not like binary search or anything. There's like into, just listen properly. The list or array. Okay, the array is divided into two parts. The sorted part towards the left side and the unsorted part towards the right side. Okay, if you take an array, left part is the sorted and the right part is unsorted. Initially, the sorted part is empty. You don't have any sorted element. Sorted part is empty. And unsorted is the entire list. So, whatever array elements that you are having, that is the unsorted. Unsorted is the entire array, entire list. Then, the smallest element is selected from the unsorted array. Okay, the smallest element is selected from the unsorted array. Unsorted array means what? The initial array that you are getting as an input itself is your unsorted array. Understood? The initial array that you are getting itself is the unsorted array. So here you have to select the smallest element is selected from the unsorted array and swapped with the leftmost element, and that element becomes a part of the sorted array. Clear? If you get any smallest element in your array, you swap it with the leftmost element. Leftmost element means the first element. Okay? And that element becomes a part of the sorted array. So I will explain it with one example. Listen carefully. This is your input array. Okay? Assume that this is your input array. What are the elements? 14, 33, 27, 10, 35, 19, 42, 44. We have to sort it. Clear? We have to sort it using the selection sort technique. Okay? We have to sort it using the selection sort technique. How will you sort? Which is the first? Tell me, the normally selection sort says that your array is divided into two parts, sorted array and unsorted array. But initially, your sorted array is empty. Which is sorted array? The leftmost part is sorted array. But now it is not sorted. We have not started it. And the right side is unsorted. Okay? So now it is not started. So sorted part is empty and unsorted is the entire array itself or the entire list. So this is my unsorted one. Now I will start. Okay? What I'll do is I'll start scanning the entire list and I want to find out which is the smallest element in this array. Clear? I'll start with the scanning the array and I will see which is the smallest element in the array. Okay, I'll start with 14. Keeping 14 in my hand, I'm checking the remaining list. Okay, keeping 14 with me, I start checking from 33 onwards. 33, 27, 10. 10 is smallest, right? 35, 19, 42, 44. Which is the smallest element? 10 is the smallest element. So what I have to do? Swap it. 10 will come here, 14 will go here. So 10 will come here, 14 will go here, and now my sorted list has started. The leftmost part is the sorted array, right? Now I have got one sorted array. What is the element in that sorted array? 10, only 10. So 10 is there in the sorted array. Next, so this much part is done. I don't have to bother about this. Now my array scanning starts from 33. With 33, I'm checking, is there any smallest element in the array, remaining array? Okay, from 33. From the next position, we start checking. So from 33, check 27, 14, 35, 19, 42, 44. Which is smallest element? 14. So what I need to do? 14 should come here and 33 should go here. Okay, to that position. So now what will come? 14 will come here, 33 will be in 14's position. So now my sorted array is 10 and 14. That is why I marked it with green color. Okay, now this is my sorted array. This is the unsorted array. Is it clear? Sorted array is this much. Unsorted array is this much. Now start scanning from the next position. J plus 1, that is 27 onwards. Okay, 33, 35, 19, 42. Which is the smallest element? 19. So what I have to do? 19 I should swap here and 27 should go to 19's position. So how it will come? 10, 14, 19, 33, 20, 35, 27, 42, 44. Now my sorted array is 10, 14, 19. Now I have to start with 33 and I have to start searching the remaining elements. Is there any other elements which is smaller than 33? Yes, 27. So what I have to do? Swap it. 27 will come here, 33 will go there. Now I have got, okay. So next what? I have to start with 35. 35, 33, 42, 44. Which is the smallest element? 33. So what I have to do? 33 should come here, 35 should go there. So now my sorted array is 10, 14, 19, 27, 33, 35, 42, 44. Now keeping 35 we will check. 42, 44. No, nothing else, no other elements. So 35 will become a part of sorted array. Then I'll start with 42 and 44. No, it is in the proper order. So 42 becomes part of array, then 44. So finally, entire list will be the sorted array. Is it clear? So always you're starting scanning from the first element. We are scanning, if there is any other smallest element, it will be swapped with the leftmost element. And leftmost, when I'm telling, don't swap in this step, don't swap 14 with 10, because 10 has become a part of sorted array. Now your array starts from 33. So the leftmost element in this array is 33. That's why we are telling that is divided into two parts, sorted and unsorted. Please see here, sorted array, I have marked it with green color. Okay. So the sorted one, you don't have to touch it. Okay. Sorted arrays, you don't have to touch it. Now in CR means 33, I have to swap 33 with 14. The 14 once I swap, it becomes part of sorted array. Now this much is my sorted array. I don't have to touch it. I have to start from 27. Is it clear? So this is how you are doing the selection sort. Okay. Take your own some other examples and start doing it. That time you will get an idea. Now we'll see the program. Okay. So same thing. You need an array. Temp variable is required because swapping is there even here. Read the number of elements. Enter the unsorted array. That means you are reading the array elements. Read it and store it in its location. Then what next? Now what is this? I equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. How many for loops? See, I is equal to 0 means that is for the first element. Okay, for I equal to 0. Okay, this element. Then the next j will start from I plus 1. That is from the this position. You are starting scanning from this way. Okay, first to 1. Keeping it in hand, then from the next element, from the next position onwards till the end, your scan. So that is why you need two for loops. Okay, for I equal to 0, I less than n, then j equal to I plus 1. I plus 1, you understood? 0 means 0 plus 1 from next position onwards till n. If a of I is greater than a of j, if there is any other element greater than that a of I, understood? If there is any other element greater than a of I, then what you have to do, you swap its position, temp equal to a of I equal to a of j, and a of j equal to temp. Swapping, the normal swapping, how we are, how I have shown in the diagram. Okay, so one now example if you want, I'll start, see the same example, for I equal to 0, I'll start from here, I equal to 0. Okay, for I equal to 0, for j equal to I plus 1. Understood? I is equal to 0 means first position, the 0th position. J equal to I plus 1 means it is in the J loop starts from here, I starts from here. And what you are checking inside that, if A of I is greater than A of J plus, A of I is greater than A of J. This is greater than this, no. Then checking again, the J loop continue, whether A of I is greater than this, whether A of I is greater than this. Like that. If they find, then it will swap here. In this case, it is greater than, so what we have to do, you have to swap it. Okay, so that is what we are showing it in the program as well. Okay, so you are swapping the positions here. You are swapping the positions. So once the positions are swapped, close this for loop, close the outer for loop, and print the sorted elements. For printing the array also, again you require for loop. Okay, for I equal to 0, I less than I plus plus, print that sorted array. This is your program. And the output is similar way. You are just randomly entering the array elements. And you will finally get a sorted elements here. Okay. So this completes the searching and sorting techniques. Once again I am repeating. Under searching you have two types. Linear search and binary search. In which binary search is a lab program. Understood? Binary search is a lab program. I had already explained in the previous video of titled Paleontrom and Binary Search. In that I have clearly explained binary search with analysis part. Then coming to sorting techniques, you have selection sort and bubble sort. Okay, bubble sort and selection sort is there. In which bubble sort is again, it is your lab program. Okay, bubble sort is again your lab program. Same program we will be doing in the lab as well. So go through the program properly, execute the program, execute that bubble sort program. Okay, and bubble sort program as well as the binary search, execute and see your output. Okay, so linear search, binary search, and under sorting, bubble sort and selection sort. So this completes the searching and sorting techniques under the module 3 arrays. Okay, so in the next session we will start with two-dimensional arrays. Okay. Thank you. Please refer your notes from page number 8 to 12 for these topics, searching and sorting techniques. Thank you.